I just want to make sure that it...
about this whole exercise was that, in my view, it was the first large cultural initiative in this country.
which realized, recognized, acknowledged, and indeed embraced the relationship between culture and the media. If you want, culture which had occupied a kind of largely private realm, in my view, in this country, and public space, and tried to utilize the public media. Now, anybody of my generation who was educated as an artist within a university would have been brought up to think about public space, the media, in a very different kind of way. And generally the position was as adversaries. As an artist, you weren't meant to embrace the media. You certainly didn't see the media as something which you could use, or as an ally in the construction and furtherance of culture. To grow an audience for art was not seen as a great priority for us. In fact, the default position for artists of my generation was to think that, in fact, you are never going to have a public role. And that is challenged by exhibitions like this. And I think it's very, very good that it is challenged by exhibitions like this. So it wasn't a surprise to me, given the education which people of my generation had, that when we started this whole enterprise, we got quite a lot of resistance from who? The art community, of all people. When I took up the role as curator of the 2004 exhibition, one of the first emails which I received was from a critic who I'm not going to name, but Cape-based for a rather small newspaper, who emailed me and said, how could this exercise possibly be genuine? They've hired a media company to run it. That was a very interesting sentence to me. Why would the hiring of a media company negate the validity of a cultural initiative? But it typified an attitude which was about a kind of preservation of a comfort zone. And that comfort zone, I think, was about we've established a little niche, elite position for culture within society, and it ain't going to get bigger. We don't have to try too hard to make it bigger. We started from exactly the opposite view, that the media was an ally. It might not always expand the views which we expanded, but we knew that if we wanted art to be something more than a conversation piece for artists and their families, we had to use the media to get a bigger kind of audience. And I don't know how many interviews I did with the other curators of the curatorial staff did, how many press meetings, how many times we were on radio, how many times we had cameras pointed at us, how many artists were interviewed. Deborah could probably tell you, but I would imagine all in all it probably went into very many hundreds. And all of that, I believe, was in fact to the benefit. And it's not always an easy thing to take what is very often a private work or a private activity, the making of art in the studio, and to give it some kind of public narrative or a story that is going to make it accessible to the public. We haven't worked very hard at that. And think about, for example, there's an artist from the town of Tom, that makes very, very beautiful, very subtle pots in a method which has remained the same for a century. Nothing new about them, nothing revolutionary about them. They're certainly not premised on the kind of value which media values, that of constant renewal. And yet, we had to interest the media in this kind of activity. So very often the most subtle of things had to find the narrative. We didn't always succeed in doing that, particularly when you think of what are the dominant narratives of the press or coming up on the plane this morning, I scanned the newspapers which were available to me to check out what are the narratives, really the narratives which define and structure the national narratives of our country. Corruption is always there. AIDS, predictably, is there. Child abuse, murder, the activities of celebrities, particularly when it's Patricia Lewis, who regards her as a porn star. And at least for some publications, the activities of homosexuals. These defining, in my view, defining national narratives reveal much about our prejudices. And it's difficult to think how the international judge of the exhibition, absolutely recognized at the start of his career, in this postmodern moment, that you can't have a career as an artist without embracing the media in some kind of way. His way was notorious, as you know, he became a film star with his wife, Chikamina. But he did go on to do other things. His reaction to Brett's death, which is recorded there, it's also very revealing because it says something about the different attitudes that people have, or that artists have, about their status in society. There's Jeff thinking, there are people lining up to assassinate an artist. I suppose the question is, does this help art? What is the benefit for us? And the other question which is begged and frequently asked is, did this help Brett? And it's a sad moment in a way for me tonight, because this is the day that we would have opened the Brett Kebble Art Awards had he not died. And I must say, coming into the gallery and seeing him on these monitors and seeing him there, it's quite affecting for me, because there's no doubt in my mind that his impulse to do this was absolutely real, genuine, and positive. Does it help art? Again, Deborah can probably give you the figures of attendance at the exhibition last year, but I think we averaged 1,000 a day. It became an event which harnessed the popular imagination. And that's a very rare thing for culture to be able to do. We had people coming in. One woman I remember said, this is the fifth time I've been, and I bring everybody from this school where the children were through to her virtue. Because it said something. Art, I think, for many people who saw the exhibition, revealed something about how to live in the post-democratic moment which politics hadn't revealed, which social narratives hadn't revealed. And that's a wonderful capacity if you think that art can do this and provide this for people. The producer of the exhibition, Deborah, often used to say to us, it became a mantra which I resented deeply, but in fact, which had a wonderful truth of art. You have to get art off the art page and onto the front page. And he's absolutely right. Needn't need be the front page, but certainly off the art page, away from the specialized press, away from the people whose job it is to preserve our culture of art. And I hope what this exhibition or this initiative has demonstrated is that, in fact, art can become an attractive option for patrons. After Brett's death, there were several appeals made or approaches made to the organizers of the exhibition with a view to taking it over. Now, many of these are made in the attic at the moment when sympathies are high and they fade just as quickly. But at least some of them have been pursued. I'm sorry to have to say tonight that, in fact, they weren't successful enough. They were a happy result, which we expect, but the news transfer hasn't happened. But I think there is still going to be good news down the line in that there are many corporations who might, or at least thinking about their own independent initiatives. I think one must say to Deborah that there is something enormously valuable in revealing what the processes of cultural production are about. Very often in these things we become used to this thinking, maybe art will stick in the gallery space, and that's the result. But in fact, for me the significance of this is how far the tentacles spread, how far the influence spreads, how many people work on the production of the art, how many people write about it, how many people manufacture it, how many people are involved in the design of it, the transport companies who take it from one place to another. In other words, the broader economy of the production of art. All of those things are important. And the media, of course, essential for me in the location of art as part of the public.
doing? How you doing?
Good, isn't it?
Okay.
Wow, how was your life?
Sublime. Was it?
Fun. After all this hard work, I think I found the risk.
I'm going to have a look at it this week.
I was in Cape Town for the last
time. I know you told
that I couldn't come.
But Deborah, Ron was fantastic.
Yeah, her and all of them were sitting on their bikes.
Oh, were they?
Spinning tops, like little children, if you could have seen them from a distance. It was just fantastic. And then there were all these people lying on the ground underneath this giant ripple, looking at the bottom of it. I mean, they did.
Well, I don't give to know.
The endeavor.